counting double-digit thousands.
What's up, Westlane? I'm Mr. Miss.
And I'm Mr. Brewer.
And welcome to Last Week at Westlane.
So, Mr. Miss, have you heard anything about sports recently?
No, I haven't.
Well, John A. made a segment about it.
Let's go check it out.
I'm here with Ms. Smith. So, how's baseball going so far?
Baseball's going really good so far. We had our first game on Tuesday. We lost, but we were hoping to get our first win tonight.
Keep it up, baseball. I'm here with Ms. Sheridan. So, what are you most looking forward to this season?
I guess what I'm most looking forward to is that we've had a really great group of girls that started early. They came to conditioning early at the end of middle of January, and they've been working up until now, and they've really put their heart and soul into it. So I'm excited to see where they go and how much we grow this season.
Keep it up, softball. Okay. I'm here with Olivia. So how was the game yesterday?
The game went really well. The score was 19-3, and I'm going to give a shout out to all the softball people, especially for the people that had did their first year because they actually got their first win.
Keep it up, softball. Hey, I'm here with Mr. Brewer. He's going to tell us a little bit about track.
So we had our first meet yesterday. We did a great job. Very proud of our team. Special shout out to Caleb McClendon, who took first in both shot put and disc. And Ms. Bailey here took first in our high jump. I was very proud of them. They did great.
Thank you. I'm here with Georgia Strikers. So what do you think of the season so far?
It's been going good. And, you know, shout out to my boy Striker. Yeah.
Yes. We took a tough one the first game, but hopefully we can bounce back. And shout out to George.
Bounce back today.
Yeah.
We'll get the victory if it's Fall Creek.
So I'm here with Miss Courtney, and she's going to tell us what she's looking forward to this season.
This season, the girls' tennis, I am really looking forward to kicking some booty. And I'm also looking forward to just building their relationships and watching the girls improve, because by the end of the season, they're totally different than the beginning.
Thank you, Miss Courtney.
You're welcome.
So I'm here with Jonah, and what do you think about baseball so far?
It's pretty good. Yesterday we had a game, and we won 17-4, and I'll give a shout out to Matthias for pitching really good for four innings and allowing zero runs.
Keep it up, baseball. I'm here with Layla. So what are you most looking forward to in track?
I'm looking forward to the Mick.
Cool. I'm here with Denijah. So who do you want to give a shout out to on the softball team?
Leah and Kate. Keep it up, guys.
All right.
Nice job, Wildcats. So, Mr. Brewer, I have a face.
Yes.
You have a face.
Yes.
Everybody at Westlane has a face.
Where are you going with this?
It's a new segment called Faces of Westlane. Let's go check it out.
All right.
Everybody, everybody wants to love. Everybody, everybody wants to be loved. Drains and light will come again. Swing open up your chest and let it in. Just let the love, love, love begin.
Hi, I'm Lucas with Help, and you're watching Last Week at Westlane.
Do, 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 do. Nice smiles, Wildcats.
So, Mr. Ramirez, have you been reading any good books recently?
Not really. Have you?
So, Mr. Ramirez, have you read any good books recently?
Not really. Have you?
Well, of course I have. I used to be an English teacher.
Okay. Well, that's nice.
Well, Mr. Urban has created a new reading segment.
Let's go watch it. Or read it. Okay.
April is National Poetry Month, so I wanted to make sure that you all know where our poetry is located in the Media Center. It is right here in our 800 section. We have a variety of poetry collections for you to look at. Almost all of these are AR books. You can take an AR test over a book of poetry. We have Langston Hughes, Tupac, Maya Angelou, a lot of books for children, children's books that have poetry in them. So please come down and check these out this month and anytime. It's great to read some short poems at this time of the year when you're kind of tired of reading very long things. Also, there are some resources that I put on the Media Center webpage for Poetry Month. At the very top is the link for April is National Poetry Month, and I have three things under here, and I'm going to add some more. This first one is NPR, National Public Radio. You can submit a poem or a tweet about poetry, and they will put it on their website. There are a lot of really cool things to read on here that students and other people have submitted, so check that out. The next site is poets.org. You can look up any poem by any poet on here. There is a lot to do on this website as well. You can sign up for Poem a Day. It's free. It gives you a poem every day to read. So just explore that. And the very last site on here is kind of for teachers maybe, but there are some things you might want to do, especially if you have young siblings at home, different activities for every day of National Poetry Month. There's some things you might do in your advisory classes. So just explore that. And I hope you come down and find some poetry to read in April. Have a great day.
Thank you for sharing, Mr. Urban.
Mr. Brewer, show me some of your dance moves.
Okay.
I'm way better.
All right, show me then. I'm pretty sure mine were better.
Well, you might win that, but I bet the kids here at Westlane did way better than us. Friday was the dance, the 90s dance, so let's go check out some footage.
Bye-bye. And then- students beat us by a long slide.
Yeah, we was at 1 and they was at 1,000.
Thanks for watching, Wildcats.
See you next week.
Friday was the 90s dance. Let's go check out some footage. Mr. Brewer, show me some of your dance moves. Mr. Brewer, show me some of your dance moves.
Okay.
Mine are way better.
Show me.
Okay. Okay.